to Ethiopia, about 113 people lost their lives last week when a landslide happened at Koshe. That is Ethiopia's largest dump site. It's in the capital Addis Ababa. 113 people died. What I don't understand is that this dump site has been there for about 48 to 50 years. This thing has been there for decades, about 5 decades, and it's been piling up, and they could see that something like this is very dangerous. It is very hazardous. They knew that something like this could happen at any time. They knew it could happen. As a matter of fact, there's a committee that was set up 15 years ago to discuss how to prevent such an occurrence. In fact, I spoke with one of the committee members, that is Mr. Emias Lagasse, and he was on the committee 15 years ago, and he spoke with me at length. He was so upset with this whole thing. He said, "Adeola, we've recommended for the government to relocate the people around that area since 15 years ago because the area is not healthy. It is hazardous to human health." He said it stinks so bad that even if you wind up your glass in the car, it still stinks. And then he said that they wanted the previous mayor, that is Ali Abdu, to buy medicines and antibiotics for the people that have been living there because everybody was getting sick. As a matter of fact, the school children at Koshe were getting sick almost every day. He said there was a time that students actually collapsed because they got sick. He also said they recommended that the government should turn the area to a biogas plant, that they should be using the dirt to produce electricity. And then the last thing he said they recommended was that they should invest in recycling instead of piling up trash. You know, they should have like recycling centers. Despite presenting their recommendations at every opportunity that they were given, at different meetings and conferences with the government, nothing was done. All their recommendations were pushed aside. In fact, the new mayor started building condominiums about 5 or 6 kilometers to the dump site. And they knew that this could happen. They knew that someday the trash are like mountains. They knew that a landslide could happen. And when it happened, guess what? It buried several houses. A lot of people were trapped beneath this trash. They started building a biogas plant without evacuating the people. And you know, this is not peculiar to Ethiopia. I mean, in Nigeria, a road is not bad until major accidents are happening and people are dying. That is when they will know, we need to repair this road. Not be so good to government buildings, dilapidated buildings. They would wait until the thing is almost crashing before they will know that they need to fix it. Hospitals, government hospitals, have you not been there? Sometimes you go to general hospital and you cannot breathe because it stinks at some of our general hospitals in Nigeria. Am I the only one? And they will just wait until everything is dilapidated before they know that they need to repair. So the government knew, at least the mayor of Koshe in Ethiopia knew, that this thing could come crashing down someday, and he didn't do anything. The government declared a 3-day mourning, and they also paid for funeral, but many people are saying it's too late. That will not bring back the dead. The damage is already done. A lot of people want the mayor to leave office, and they are saying that they shouldn't have waited till people died. Now, for those who lost their loved ones, I cannot imagine what you're going through. Please accept our condolences. May their souls rest in peace. You guys know I don't know much. Guess what? I'm just keeping it real.